can move things with my mind.
It does that on its own. You are so out of touch.
Miss Worldwide, let's celebrate. Yeah. If you know me, then you know what I'm famous. Off in the Bahamas with a bad one behind me. Now live it up, live it up, live it up. Baby, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And we gon'
boom, boom, all around the world. Boom, boom, go get it, girl. Boom, boom, that's the way we like to play.
Wow, I am so happy. Are you ready?
Oh!
Westin Bonaventure Hotel and Suites in downtown Los Angeles. Welcome to the 43rd Annual Daytime Emmy Awards. And now, please give a huge round of applause to two of daytime's biggest superstars, Elmo and Rosita.
Rosita, thank you so much for the kind words. I'm really, really flattered by that. But I'm a big fan of yours.
Really?
Big fan, yes.
Me?
And yours too, Elmo.
Oh, thank you, Mr.
Big
Mario.
Fan.
Oh, are you the real Mario?
Yes, no. Well, we'll talk about that later. But I wanted you guys to know, did you realize some of the biggest names in television are here in this ballroom with us tonight?
That's right.
Yes.
Yeah.
We've got Anthony Geary here somewhere. Who, by the way, could tie the world record tonight for the most Emmy wins by a performer.
Wow.
Okay.
Sir, I love you as Fluke and Luke. That's
wow.
Fair.
Yes, he's great as Fluke.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah, yeah.
We also have my buddy Dr. Oz.
Dr. Oz
is here.
Hello, Dr. Oz.
Dr. Oz is one heck of a basketball player, if you don't know.
You know what, Elmo? Elmo loved your special on digestion. It was fascinating.
Yes. We also have Emma and Spencer from General Hospital.
Yeah.
They're here.
Hey,
they look wonderful.
Yes,
hey,
we do love them.
Maria is here. Look, Maria.
Maria, hello,
where's Maria?
Maria.
Oh, there's Maria.
Maria, yes, baby.
Yes.
Well, you know, Emma heard that Maria is getting a reward tonight. You know, so maybe she'll buy Elmo an ice cream with her reward money?
Well, Maria's not actually getting a reward. she's going to be getting an award, and a very important one too. She's actually getting a Lifetime Achievement Award tonight.
Really?
A little later in the show. Well-deserved one too.
Mr. Mario.
Yes.
Can we help give her the award?
Oh, yes, please.
Absolutely. I wouldn't even think of doing it without you. So we're going to see you guys a little later in the show, okay?
Oh, yes. We'll see you later.
Bye. For now. Rosita, bye.
Adios.
Thank you. All right. Well, now that the kids are gone, let's get this thing going. This was quite a provocative, groundbreaking, and sexy year on daytime television. The game shows made people rich. The talk shows covered every topic under the rainbow. We all gained a little weight thanks to the culinary shows. We traveled all around the world. Our children were educated and entertained. We saw a major transgender storyline tackled. Beloved characters from the past returned to days of our lives. Babies were literally stolen and given to different parents. Oh, it was a great year. So, with all that said, why don't we honor these fine folks by giving out some awards, huh? Now, I'm gonna guide you through a few sections tonight, and then my buddies Nancy O'Dell and Kevin Frazier are gonna be up here and guide you a little later. With all that said, our very first award to kick things off tonight honors our supporting actors. A nomination in this category is a tribute in itself, as there are so many entrants and so much talent. Here are the nominees.
Sean Blakemore as Sean Butler, General Hospital, ABC. Steve Burton as Dylan Metrovolza, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Brighton James as Devon Hamilton, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Jacob Young as Rick Forrester, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Dominic Zambrogia as Dante Falconeri, General Hospital, ABC.
And the Emmy goes to Sean Blakemore, Sean Butler, General Hospital, ABC. Sean's looking good these days.
Sean is out of town filming, and he wanted me to accept on his behalf. He wants to thank Frank Valentini and the Emmys for this awesome award, and we got one. Thank you.
Please welcome the Emmy-nominated hosts of The Talk, Julie Chen, Sarah Gilbert, Sharon Osbourne, Aisha Tyler, and Cheryl Underwood.
All right. What's the first thing you do when you wake up in the morning?
I brush my teeth.
I brush my hair, obviously.
I brush my dog's hair, of course.
Sharon, did you get that brush out of my dressing room?
Oh, yeah.
Let's all brush up on the nominees for Outstanding Morning Program.
CBS Sunday Morning, CBS. CBS This Morning, CBS. Good Morning America, ABC. Today Show, NBC.
Yeah, that's you.
Going to me.
Yeah. No. Oh, that's me. And the Emmy goes to?
Oh.
CBS Sunday Morning. CBS.
Thank you.
Our thanks. First of all, from the best producer I've ever had the pleasure of working with, Rand Morrison, and from the rest of the wonderful people who make this program possible every week. Thank you to the Academy, and thank you again.
Please welcome the host of The Chase, Emmy nominee Brooke Burns, and the host of Crime Watch Daily, Matt Doran.
The nominated shows for talk show entertainment have become staples in our lives.
They really have, and each has a very unique take and style, and of course, all of them are worthy of an Emmy tonight.
That's right, but only one can win. Here are the nominees.
The Ellen DeGeneres Show, syndicated. The Real, syndicated. The Talk, CBS. The View, ABC. The Wendy Williams Show, syndicated.
All right, and the Emmy goes to...
Let me do the honors. Thank you. Let's see. The Talk, CBS!
Us look good every day. I'm going to read this because I don't want to forget anybody, and I will. Let me get my code in properly. I just want to say I never thought an idea that I had in my bathtub 7 years ago would end us up here, and there are so many people that got us here that we want to thank. So we want to thank Leslie Moonves, Glenn Geller, David Staff, Nina Tassler, Angelica McDaniel, and everybody at CBS for being behind this idea from day one. John Redman, Heather Gray, and Kristen Matthews truly bring the show to life every day, and most importantly, get us on the air on time and off the air on time, which is the biggest feat of all. Our producers and our crew who seamlessly run the show, and we're biased, but everybody who comes to the show says that they're the greatest, most professional staff in town. So we thank them. And to Julie, Aisha, Sharon, and Cheryl, I think it was just some amazing alchemy that brought us together. You guys are this show, and we would never be here without you. To the Academy, thank you for giving us something to talk about tomorrow. And to our viewers, you know, you were part of the original idea that we all wanted to be. I wanted everyone to feel more connected, and that's what we want. So you are our show also, and we thank you for showing up. Thank you so much.
Welcome to Emmy nominees for talk show informative host. They have a long-standing relationship. From The Chew, Daphne Oz. And from The Dr. Oz Show, Dr. Menon Oz.
We narrowly avoided the talk flash mob. But they may be back. We'll find out. Daphne is a loving father. I've got my wonderful daughter next to me again, my stiffest competition. And as a loving father, we're going to go at this again. We'll see how it works out this time in the competition.
Yes. Okay. Here we are as a loving father-daughter pair, rivals. I wish you all the luck in the world, of course. But let's not forget who won last year. I see you, too.
Yeah, we brought her up that way to compete. No, I still feel she made me fried Oreos, which I don't know how you can do that. I didn't like it at all. Anyway.
All right, we are here to present the nominees for Entertainment Talk Show Host.
Adrian Bailon, Tamar Braxton, Lonnie Love, Jeannie Mai, and Tamara Mowry-Housley, co-hosts The Real Syndicate. Julie Chen, Sarah Gilbert, Sharon Osbourne, Aisha Tyler, and Cheryl Underwood, co-hosts The Talk, CBS. Whoopi Goldberg, Joy Behar, Candace Cameron Bure, Paula Faris, Raven Simone, Nicole Wallace, Rosie Perez, and Michelle Collins, co-hosts The View, ABC. Yeah. Kelly Ripa and Michael Strahan, co-hosts Live with Kelly and Michael, syndicated. Wendy Williams, host The Wendy Williams Show, syndicated.
And the Emmy goes to...
Kelly Ripa and Michael Strahan, live with Kelly and Michael.
I don't think they're here. So... Since I know them well, we'll accept on their behalf, and Kelly and Michael will share it.
Congratulations, you guys.
We accept.
Please welcome two nominees in the Younger Actor and Actress categories. From The Young and the Restless, Hunter King. And from The Bold and the Beautiful, Pearson Podet.
A district attorney, a fashion industry maven, a psychic matriarch, a lawyer, and a mother lioness fiercely protecting her cub.
And no, these are not clues for a game show. No, that category's coming up next. Laugh at my joke, Hunter.
I'm sorry.
But they are the roles being played by the five beautiful and talented women in this category.
Here are the nominees for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama Series.
Laura Lee Bell as Christine Williams, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Jessica Collins as Avery Bailey Clark, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Lindsay Gottfried as Caroline Spencer, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Peggy McKay as Caroline Brady, Days of Our Lives, NBC. Melissa Reeves as Jennifer Horton, Days of Our Lives, NBC.
And the Emmy goes to
Jessica Collins!
Share this with you. I miss you so much. Jill, Farron Phelps, Steve Kent, Angelica McDaniel, Chuck Pratt, and all of our writers who work so hard for us. We couldn't do this without you. Oh my gosh, the crew. Thank you so much for taking care of me. The cast, Steve, there you are. And Josh, and Gina, and Christian. Thank you for upping my game as an actress every time I work with you. I want to thank my girls, Lisa Melamed and Marnie Sparrow. You are always there for me. I love you. I share this with you. You know why. Thank you to Thomas Cushing and my agents, Innovative Artists, for representing me. And I want to thank the fans. You have been so wonderful to me, and I am so grateful for you. And I want to thank my family, Spencer, Oliver, Lucy, and Gemma. You inspire me every day. And Michael, you're somewhere over there. I'm so happy to be sharing all of this time with you. You have given me the most wonderful things in my life. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Please welcome the Emmy-nominated hosts of The Real, Adrian Bylone, Tamar Braxton, Lonnie Love, Jenny Mai, and Tamara Mowry Housley.
I know. We are so happy to be here. Everybody having a good time so far? Come on.
Aw, thank you.
Let's do the pose.
Here we
Let's
go.
Do the pose. Hit a pose.
Boom.
Hit a pose.
Ready.
Ready.
We'll give you the answers, you give us the questions.
Be careful what deal you make or you could get zonked.
Child, go ahead on and work your way to the $1 million question.
Work your way around the Monopoly board. Guess the price, but don't go over. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Game Show.
Jeopardy. Syndicated. Let's Make a Deal. CBS. Monopoly Millionaires Club. Syndicated. The Price is Right. CBS. Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? Syndicated.
Sorry. And the Emmy goes to Jeannie Hittem.
The Price is Right. CBS.
The Emmy, Mike Richards, executive producer.
That is a catchy tune. Thank you very much. That's a catchy tune. We are so proud to do this show. We are so proud of the legacy that it has. We're so proud to do it for CBS and Angelica McDaniel and her amazing team. And where's Margo Wayne? Everybody give it up for Margo Wayne. Everybody loves Margo Wayne. There she is. We need more people that work on our show after the talk came up. I realized that. We will be renegotiating that later because we need a lot more people. But we have an amazing team. Give them a round of applause. One thing I want to say, this is a room filled with people who work really hard to do what they do. And when you work really hard, you have people that support you. And I would guess that in this room, there are a lot of people that support them that are here, and there are a lot of people that support them at home. So if you guys would, there are people that give us all the power to do this. And on behalf of all of those people, I want to say thank you. I want to specifically thank my mom, who comes every year, Carol. I want to thank my wife, who thought it was an amazing idea for me to executive produce two game shows. We nailed it. I want to thank my boys, Carson, Tate, Luke. Good job. And I want to thank our amazing, amazing team. I want to thank Drew Carey, who without this, we couldn't do it. He should be here, but he's on the road right now. Check his Instagram. It's freaky. And I want to thank the Academy. Thank you so much. This means so much. Pride.
from Days of Our Lives. Welcome Jen Lilly and Billy Flynn.
Thank you. A game show host has to be intelligent, quick on the draw, and charming while keeping the game moving with similar skills as an air traffic controller.
Oh, wow, that sounds super complicated. I think I'm just going to stick to memorizing a lot of lines and wearing fabulous clothes and being able to cry on cue.
Oh. Yeah. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Game Show Host.
Wayne Brady. Let's Make a Deal. CBS. Brooke Burns. The Chase. Game Show Network. Greg Ferguson. Celebrity Name Game, syndicated. Billy Gardell, Monopoly Millionaires Club, syndicated. Steve Harvey, Family Feud, syndicated.
And the Emmy goes to...
Craig Ferguson.
Accepting the Emmy, Scott St. John, executive producer.
I'm sure if Craig were here, he would say thank you very much to the Academy. He is very grateful and very absent, but we thank you. And on behalf of the staff that worked so hard in the show, thank you guys for making him look so good. Thank you.
Please welcome from General Hospital, Teresa Castillo, and from Days of Our Lives, Camila Benus.
Teresa, estoy tan orgullosa y feliz que nos pidieron presentar a estos premios para la categoría de idioma español.
Yo también. Esos programas son vistos y juzgados como estaban destinados a ser vistos, en español, por jueces que hablan español.
Claro. You know what? I think we should probably let them in on what we're talking about, right?
Good idea.
Okay, yeah, let's take that from the top.
All right.
So, Teresa, look, I'm really proud and happy that we got asked to present these awards for Spanish language programming.
Me too. These programs are viewed and judged as they were meant to be seen in Spanish by Spanish-speaking judges.
Our first category is Entertainment Program in Spanish.
Here are the nominees.
Clicks, CNN en Español. Destinos, CNN en Español. Fuerza en Movimiento, CNN en Español. Super Latina con Gaby Natale. Super Latina, VME TV, Aguilar Media. Vive la Salud con la doctora Azare, CNN en Español.
And the Emmy goes to... Super Latina with Gaby Natal, Super Latina, Agradecida. BME TV.
Accepting the Emmy, Gaby Natale, executive producer and host.
That are holding today a daytime Emmy are the same hands that were holding a bucket of paint and a brush 10 years ago to paint our first TV set of Super Latina. My partner in business and life, Andy Suarez, we created Super Latina from a carpet warehouse in Odessa, Texas, just because we wanted to produce television that inspired us. So this award goes to the dreamers, to the rebels, to the ones that wake up every day and do not allow any one to define their capabilities. You're never too old, you're never too fat, too ugly, too gay, or too undocumented to make your dream come true. Thank you so much. Gracias a todos.
Our next category is Morning Program in Spanish. Here are the nominees.
Café CNN, CNN en español, Despierta América, Univision, Un Nuevo Día, Telemundo.
And the Emmy goes to Café CNN, CNN en español.
Accepting the Emmy, Alejandra Juana, Anchor.
Wow. This is truly a dream come true. First of all, we have to thank everyone who has made Café CNN happen for the last 5 years, Cynthia Hudson, Eduardo Suarez, who have believed on our programming, who have believed on the public of Spanish-speaking language in America. Obviously, to our wonderful co-anchors, producers, Maria Alejandra Requena, Carlos Montero, Samuel Burke, Eli Perez, and especially for all the Latinos that watch us every day, and every single Latino that, like me, like Maria Alejandra, like Eduardo, came to this country to make their dreams come true, that worked hard every single day to make this country better. And well, me personally, for all the Venezuelans that live in the US and have made the US much better. Eduardo Suarez, please, the stage is yours.
Thank you. We know when we bring Café CNN on the road to Summit of the America in Panama in this year, that was an excellent idea, and we basically stolen the event. Thank you, Ben Fernandez, editorial director, David Gámez, production manager. Thanks to Cynthia Hudson, that is always paving the road for us to walk together. So thank you very much.
I just want to thank CNN in Español, United States of America, because it's a really, really good place. It's a great place to be a family, to work, to dream, because dreams can come true. Thank you, Daytime Emmy, and thank you, Venezuela, for the support. Viva Venezuela!
The final Spanish award for outstanding daytime talent in a Spanish language program.
I guess we don't qualify, right?
Not really. Okay, no. Let's take a look at the nominees.
Carlos Calderón, correspondent El Gordo y la Flaca, Univision. Elizabeth Hernandez Curiel, correspondent El Gordo y la Flaca, Univision. Camilo Egana, Anchor, Encuentro, CNN en Español. Raúl de Molina, co-host, El Gordo y la Flaca, Univision. Gabby Natale, host, Super Latina con Gabby Natale. Super Latina, VME TV, Aganar Media.
And the Emmy goes to Gabriela Natal. Super Latina with Gabby Natal.
Thank you.
Thank you to the Academy. Thank you, God. My family, Roberto, Cristina, Francisco, Alejandro, my partner in business and life. Te amo, Andy. My amazing team, Paulina, Champ, and everybody. And also, I want to tell you, I became a better professional when I embraced more of who I was and less what it was expected in this industry that want to change us so much. In the beginning, I was so self-conscious about hosting events in English, doing coverages in English, but two words kept me calm and gave me confidence every time, and I'm gonna reveal them to you. If you're feeling nervous, those two words are Arnold Schwarzenegger. Because if he with that accent could become a legend in Hollywood and then the governor of the seventh economy of the world, so can I and so can you. Thank you so much.
Please welcome the Emmy-winning host of Lucky Dog, Brandon McMillan.
Everyone backstage thought this was a police dog. The five characters played by the nominees for Younger Actress in a Drama Series have all had quite an emotional and dramatic year. All actresses rose to the challenge, delivering moving and compelling performances. Let's take a look at the nominees.
So sad. Rainn Edwards as Nicola Vance, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Hunter King as Summer Newman, The Young and the Restless, CBS. True O'Brien as Paige Larson, Days of Our Lives, NBC. Ashlyn Pierce as Allie Forrester, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Brooklyn Ray Silzer as Emma Drake, General Hospital, ABC.
And the Emmy goes to True O'Brien as Paige Larson, Days of Our Lives, NBC.
Collaborators. I want to thank my loving boyfriend in real life, Casey Moss, and my amazing on-screen mom, Cassie DePaiva, who taught me so much about acting and about life, and I love them, and I'm forever indebted to them. I want to thank my management. I want to thank Albert and Greg Meng, and Bruce and Ken Corday, and thank you so much. To the Academy, and I'll stop talking now so you all can enjoy your evening. Okay, thank you.
From the doctors, please welcome Dr. Andrew Ardon and Dr. Jennifer Ashton.
I must say, you are looking particularly healthy this evening.
Coming from a plastic surgeon, Drew, that's very high praise. But we need to praise some other people. These five very talented young men in this category are the supporting and leading actor nominees of the future.
And the prognosis is good that they will all be around for a very long time.
Here are the nominees for Outstanding Younger Actor in a Drama Series.
Nicholas Bechtel as Spencer Cassidy, General Hospital, ABC. Ryan Craig as Morgan Corinthos, General Hospital, ABC. Max Eric as Fenmore Baldwin, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Pearson Foday as Thomas Forrester, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Taquan Richmond as TJ Ashford, General Hospital, ABC.
And the Emmy goes to...
Brian Craig as Morgan Corinthos, General Hospital, ABC.
Straight to my paper. I'm so nervous. There's so many people I want to thank. First of all, thank you to the Daytime Emmys for recognizing my work. I really appreciate that. My mom, my dad, my brother, my beautiful fiance, Kelly, thank you for dealing with all my craziness coming home every day from work. I appreciate you. I love you to death. My manager, Richie, my agent, Galik, Frank Valentini, thank you for giving me the job and having faith in me. All the producers, Ron, thank you for giving me this story and trusting me with it. I appreciate that. All the writers, our crew, my co-stars. I want to give a special thanks to Maurice Bernard for just having my back and just letting me in on his personal experience with mental illness and stuff. The fans, thank you. I want to share this with anyone that suffers from mental illness in real life. It's been an honor to promote awareness, and I just want to say don't be scared to get help. Thank you so much.
Please give a warm welcome to Emmy Award-winning host, author, and survivor, Sandra Lee.
Hello. Good evening. I'm so grateful to be here to introduce a socially important segment this evening. One year ago this month, I chose to go public and share my cancer diagnosis. Daytime television has pioneered public awareness and health and social issues with programming that lifted stigmas and opened conversations. Conversations like those lead to action, action that saves lives. It's the reason I had early detection, and I am now thankfully cancer-free. Daytime television has taken on issues such as AIDS, alcoholism, mental health, marriage equality, SIDS, autism, homelessness, and of course cancer, among so many others. So to the writers and to the producers, and the actors who have portrayed these issues authentically, bravely, and with sensitivity, we all applaud you. Here's just a small sampling of the many important social issues that have been addressed over the years.
You're not my sister, Maya. You're not Maya at all. You're Myron. You're my brother.
This just happens, you know that. I mean, there isn't really much known about sudden infant death syndrome. Crib death, sometimes it just strikes a perfectly healthy baby.
Maybe if I checked him,
Marlene,
but sir, and we had loved him.
Don't torment yourself.
My name is Nikki, and I'm an alcoholic.
Do you have any idea how hard it is to live with cancer?
I am living with it.
You want to face it? Oh, let's face it together. Here, face this.
For the past 3 days, Theo has been undergoing tests with Dr. Litton. And today, she told us that Theo is autistic.
I'm HIV positive.
I tested positive for HIV. Look. I don't have AIDS.
I did this to you.
You didn't do anything to me.
What do you guys think? You think I'm like him? You think I'm like Dad?
Bipolar disorder can be hereditary.
A lot of times, people who are bipolar, it starts in their 20s. I was about your age when my life changed.
Stop. I'm not sick. Okay.
Do you think I like taking my medication? Do you think I like taking my medication? But you know why I take it? Because if I don't take it, I turn into a wrecking ball.
I love you and I support you. No matter what.
Even if I'm a gay man?
No matter what.
Did you notice? I said I'm gay.
She does have two parents. Dan and I. We're her parents. We're a couple and we've been together a really long time.
You have clinical stage 3 prostate cancer.
What does that mean?
The cancer has spread beyond the outer layer of the prostate, but it hasn't reached the lymph nodes, which is a positive sign. Now, there are several treatment options to consider. The first one is radiation.
You have had a problematic history up until now with men.
Wait a second.
No, you wait a second. You've been abused. You've been married. All of this has taken a tremendous emotional toll on you.
So you're saying that me having feelings for women is because I've had a bad history with men?
I, Jackson, take you, Will,
to be my lawfully wedded husband.
It is my very great honor to pronounce you husbands for life.
Where are we?
Central City East, otherwise known as Skid Row.
I promised I'd make a difference. Instead, when I see them, I turn away. What have I done with my life? What is my burden compared to theirs?
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, Mario Lopez and friends.
It is time now for a very, very important part of our show. It is time to talk all about Maria. We love Maria. Actually, Sonia Manzano to all of you.
Yes, we love you very, very much, Maria. Yes. Yeah, let's hear it for her.
Yes, let's hear it for her. What?
Maria is mi querida amiga, and she has taught me so many things.
And you know what? She helped Elmo and all of Elmo's friends learn to count and to read and to be better monsters.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. And she helped me be proud of my Latin heritage.
Very important.
Yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you were actually the ring bearer at her wedding, weren't you, Elmo?
That's true. Elmo was the ring bearer.
Right.
And Elmo wore the same tux.
Yeah.
And you know what? Maria is the best person I know.
Yeah.
She is. Well, she is. Well, here's the thing, Rosita. She's taught a lot of us here who grew up over the last 45 years all about life in general, about the good times and getting through the challenging times. She is absolutely one of the most beloved people in the whole world. In fact, we have a very special message right now for Maria, I mean, Sonia, from someone who thinks she's pretty special too. He's a big Broadway star. Have you guys ever been to a Broadway show?
No,
Elmo, Rosita?
No? But you know what? Elmo's trying to score some tickets to Hamilton.
Yeah, a lot of people.
Do you know anybody?
A lot of people are trying to score tickets to Hamilton. Well, lucky for us, we have a connection to Mr. Alexander Hamilton himself, Lin-Manuel Miranda, who has a message especially for Sonia Manzano.
Oh, we love Lin-Manuel.
Let's take a look.
For so many years, the only Latina on TV we had was Maria on Sesame Street. You were the lone voice in the wilderness. You raised us, you taught us to read. And none of us would be where we are without you. Congratulations, Sonia. We love you. Mwah! Abrazo.
Yeah. Mario, now can we show Maria how important she is to us?
Oh, yeah, Mr. Mario. When does Maria get her reward?
Yeah, the
award. She's not getting a reward, you're getting an award.
Yes.
Let me tell you a little something about Sonia before that happens, okay?
Yes.
She literally let us watch her grow up and let us share Maria's life, enchanting and teaching two generations of young people. Her talent as an actress and as a musical performer made learning fun and easy, and kids really responded to it. Sonia started her career in the original cast of Godspell, and then she joined Sesame Street shortly thereafter. She's won 15 Emmy Awards as a writer, written critically acclaimed books, and has been honored with many, many other awards, including the Congressional Hispanic Caucus Award and the Hispanic Heritage Award for Education. And now, we would like to welcome a special friend who would like to share what she loves about Sonia as well. She just happens to be an Emmy, Grammy, Oscar, and Tony Award winner. And she has a career that has spanned over 70 years and is still going strong. Please join me in welcoming Miss Rita Moreno.
Sorry, I couldn't help it. Don't play that music. Shh. We're honoring someone very special, and I think we should do that by being quiet and respectful. Maria, I once met a girl named Maria, and I will never forget our first meeting. I recall it vividly, by the trash can, and that bird's nest, near the subway, across from the bicycle shop. next to the laundromat, just up from Hooper's store. As an ignorant child, but also an immigrant child, I had grown up on Main Streets, taunted, jeered, made to feel less than. But on this particular street where I met you, Maria, children of every color, every ethnicity played in safety. They were accepted, valued, as they learned how to become productive citizens in a diverse community. I've learned. I have learned that within 10 years of my visit, by the time they were 3 years old, 95% of all American children had visited that very street. And they had met Maria too. Of course, I'm speaking of you, Sonia Manzano, the Maria of Sesame Street. Let me tell you that an author named Malcolm Gladwell wrote, "Sesame Street was built around a single breakthrough insight that if you can hold the attention of children, you can educate them." Querida Sonia, darling Sonia, you have been a mentor, a guide, a cheerleader, a friend, an attendant, inspiration, a teacher, an exemplar for over two generations of children, because you loved and valued them, you did actually hold their attention, and you did educate them. Fernanda Luisa, my beloved daughter, was one of the millions of children that grew up on your street. As a fellow actor, I say felicidades, congratulations on your long and successful career. And as a mom, I want to say with the deepest gratefulness, thank you. So, let's take a look at Sonia's work over the last 44 years.
Each time we meet at work or the street, we always say hello. But you say
hola,
and I say hola.
It's a word that we both know.
My name is Maria.
Maria?
Yeah.
One of these things is not like the others. Which one is different, do you know? Tell me which thing is not like the others, and I'll tell you if it is so.
I should have known.
Once upon a time, there was a beautiful young princess. There she is.
Snooky, how's my hair? On? Yes, I know it's on. Oh, I'm on! No, wait a minute. Here I am in my hometown after all these years. I'm back in the place where I was born.
Happy birthday, Maria.
Big Bird. Don't you remember we told you? Mr. Hooper died. He's dead.
I'm gonna miss you, Mr. Looper.
That's Hooper, Big Bird. Hooper.
We are here today to celebrate the marriage of Maria and Luis.
It's altogether possible I've made a major error. My hands are cold, my forehead's hot. It's either love or terror. I guess somewhere there's some somebody who thinks a wedding's fun. But if I weren't five stories high, I'd run.
Look at her.
Oscar!
Yeah, well, get in.
Oscar, I love you.
Okay.
Bye. Bye. Little baby, I want you to meet all our friends.
Hi, little, gee, what's your name?
Gabriela.
I have two prizes. Look at this, the most excellent teeth club.
Mommy, could you take a break and help us with the conga?
My home.
Don't worry, Big Bird. We're all gonna help you, and we're gonna fix this.
What's that?
It's a smoke alarm.
Alan, look!
Smoke!
Something's on fire in the kitchen.
I'll get the fire extinguisher.
I'll call the fire department. Come on, Elmo. Stay low and go.
I'm proud that I speak Spanish. Well, it's such a beautiful language, and it's a part of who I am.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what?
What?
It's a part of who you are, too.
Siete, siete, rumba, rumba. Siete, siete, chiquibumba.
Oh, hey, hola. This is my friend, Supreme Court Justice Sonia Sotomayor.
Hi, everybody.
Un cafecito?
Sí, gracias.
I love having an audience.
Wow. On behalf of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, I am thrilled to present the Daytime Emmy for Lifetime Achievement to Sonia Manzano.
Of love. I have to tell you that I was thrilled to know that Rita Moreno was going to be here because if truth be told, it all started with Rita Moreno and my fourth grade teacher, Miss Shirley Pellman, who took me to see West Side Story when I was 11 years old. And Rita made hanging out on rooftops glamorous, and she made being a seamstress important, and she made kissing hot boys in hallways a very good thing to do, and these were activities I was very familiar with. And then she went on to entertain us all with the most wonderful tyrannical director of German descent electric company had ever seen. Thank you, Rita. I'll never forget the first time I saw Sesame Street. I walked into the student union of Carnegie Mellon University, and there was a very young, very bald James Earl Jones reciting the alphabet in a very deliberate manner. A, B, C, as the letters flashed over his head. Well, I thought I was watching a show that taught lip reading. But then they cut to the street and I saw Susan and Gordon. a black couple talking to me from an inner city street. Now, this was something you did not see on television in 1969. And I knew at that moment that Sesame Street was more than letters and numbers. Still, when I got cast as Maria, I asked the wonderful producers, John Stone and Dulcie Singer, what Maria should be like. And they kept saying, be yourself, and be natural, and be real. Because they knew that the first Latina these kids were going to see on television should not be their notion of what a Latina was like. It should be me, myself, and I. Well, we're all actors, so what could I do but run with it? So it resulted in very snarky, real conversations with Oscar the Grouch, exasperating conversations, but real ones with Big Bird, and serious flirtations with male cast member characters, David, Luis, and even Grover. And you know what? The kids appreciated the reality. They knew that it was good to have someone that was like the parents that were in their households, but in a good way. And I know they appreciated because they grew up and they told me. And they always say, Sonia, you don't know. And I want to say now that I do know. I do know and I appreciate the stories they tell. The beautiful Sesame Street cast is here with me. Loretta Long, Emilio Delgado, Bob McGrath, Alan Marocca, Allison Bartlett. They are people of substance. I love them so much that when I was going to get married, it was their approval that I sought as the choice of my husband. I wanted them to approve of him even more than I wanted my mother to approve of him. And speaking of husbands, if there's one person in this room who could possibly feel happier than I feel now, it's my husband, Richard Reagan. Because that's just how he rolls. And thank you, my daughter, Gabriella Reagan, for being who you are. I love television. I escaped a chaotic childhood by losing myself in the stories I saw on television. And I grew up to be able to provide that same kind of comfort for children in similar situations. I love television. It's powerful. And let's continue to make it the best form that it can be. Gracias. Gracias.
From the Chew and Larry King now, please welcome to tonight's Emmy nominees, Carla Hall and Larry King.
Lifetime Achievement winner. Your work is legendary and they all know it. That's what they're clapping for. Yeah. And it's an honor to be chosen to acknowledge the work of these four directing teams.
Each team expertly and creatively turns out over 250 shows a year, and they are some of the smoothest and best looking shows on all of television.
The nominees for Outstanding Drama Series Directing Team.
The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Days of Our Lives, NBC.
General Hospital, ABC. The Young and the Restless, CBS.
And the Emmy goes to... I'll open it, you read it.
Okay. And the Emmy goes to General Hospital, ABC!
Accepting the Emmy, William Lugell, director.
Here's what's really cool about this. We're still here. Not just us on the stage, but all of us, we're still on the air. We're still doing our work. We're telling our stories. We're producing episode after episode. There have been a lot of changes over the past couple of years, some good changes, some changes that might not be so good. But what has never changed and never will change is the effort from everyone, no matter what the obstacles in our path, the effort to make our shows as exciting and true and entertaining as possible. We're fighting the good fight, and we deserve to be very proud of ourselves. We share this Emmy with our magnificent, hardworking crew, with our writers led by Ron Carlovati, Shelley Altman, Jean Passanante, Elizabeth Cordy, our producers, our executive producer and fellow director, Frank Valentini, Vicki Dummer, and all our supporters at ABC, and of course our cast, who make us shine every day. Thank you.
From the bold and the beautiful, here are Carla Moseley and Jacob Young.
As actors on a daytime drama, our writers are our heroes. They make our characters who they are, and they allow us to come alive and then to thrive.
A good script is the best gift an actor can receive, except, well, maybe for a daytime Emmy.
So, here are the nominees for Outstanding Drama Series Writing Team.
The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. General Hospital, ABC. The Young and the Restless, CBS.
All right, and the nominees and the winner and all of that jazz.
The Emmy.
Well, because I don't know how it exactly goes these days, but you have to be politically correct.
So the Emmy goes to the Bold and the Beautiful.
The Emmy, Bradley Bell, head writer and executive producer.
It's very nerve-wracking for a writer to be up here, so just give me a minute. Arnold Schwarzenegger. Okay, I'm good. First, I'd like to acknowledge the brilliant writing team we have here, my co-head writer, Michael Minnis, the brilliant Patrick Mulcahy, Adam Ducevoir, Michelle Valjean, Tracy Kelly, Shannon Bradley, Jack Smith, and Rex Best, who's not here with us. Our producers, Rhonda Friedman, 29 Years Together, Ed Scott, Casey Kasperzik, Mark Benchotti, Cindy Pop, and our incredible cast who brought this transgender story to life. Carla Moseley, Jacob Young, Ray Anna. I'd like to also thank Nick Adams at GLAAD for beautifully coaching us through this story. They were tremendous help. And there's a very special woman here who is the co-creator of The Young and the Restless and The Bold and the Beautiful, and my mom, Lee Philip Bell. And another very special lady who could not be here tonight. I'd like to thank my wife, Ambassador Colleen Bell, and all the Americans serving overseas and everyone at the U.S. Embassy Budapest. I know they're cheering us on. Our CBS daytime team is absolutely brilliant. Angelica McDaniel, thank you for your leadership. Margo Wayne, for your invaluable support. The whole CBS lineup is a great place to call home. Come on up here, Mom. Yeah, how about... Thank you, Mom. And finally, I'd like to thank the soap opera community. First, the Academy, Bob Morrow and David Michaels, but the soap opera community, Bold and Beautiful, is almost 30 years old. YNR 43, Days and GH over 50. They're still killing it. It's remarkable achievements by all. So thank you very much for this honor.
Please welcome from the Bay, Christos Andrews, and from Eastsiders, Van Hansis.
Before we get started, I would like to congratulate you, Christos, on winning last night for Outstanding Actor in a Digital Drama Series.
Thank you, Rob. I appreciate that. It's actually amazing that I was able to be considered amongst such great talent, especially you, bro. I appreciate that.
Thank you so much.
Last year, the National Academy brought this category back after an absence of many years, and it has become huge. The fierce competition and the performances are superb.
It is no easy task to walk into a cast that really know each other and instantly fit in and thrive, but here are five people who did just that.
Here are the nominees for Guest Performer in a Drama Series.
Oba Babatunde as Julia Savant, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Anna Maria Horsford as Vivian Avant, The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Adam Ledbetter as Dr. Malcolm, Days of Our Lives, NBC. Frank Runyon as Angel, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Dee Wallace as Patricia Spencer, General Hospital, ABC.
And the Emmy goes to Oba Babatunde!
I stand here tonight before you, a man who is humbled by the experience, appreciative of the acknowledgement. I'm big on family, so I would like to thank family first. I don't just identify family as my immediate family, an extended family, because we accept and acknowledge each other every single day with love and affection. But I want to talk about my artistic family. First, my agent of 30 years. It's a 30-year relationship. Stoneman and Salners and every single individual in that office that works every single day to make sure that every one of their clients get the kind of respect that they deserve. Thank you. Particular Adrian. My manager, Marjorie Weiner, who every single day starts her life off with this concept. A standard of excellence, or it doesn't matter. Marjorie, thank you. And my Bold and the Beautiful family, headed by Brad Bell. Every single one, nominated or not, winner or not, every single day they come down that hallway just like me to bring to fore the very best that they have to offer. Those individuals set a platform by which I stand on tonight and hold this award, and so I thank you, each and every one of you. The daytime community who has accepted me with open arms, I thank you. And every one of you, the fans, of course, for your appreciation and sometimes your disapproval, because it helps us to continue to be the very best at what we do. What I identify is this, and I share this with you all. In life, as you do anything is how you do everything. It is very easy to tell a dirty glass by putting a clean glass next to it. In this room, I suggest that there is nothing in here but clean glasses. Continue to be that, and we shall continue to represent ourselves throughout the world community. God bless each and every one of you, and thank you.
Please welcome two-time Emmy nominee and host of The Insider, Debbie Matenopoulos, and from General Hospital, Donnell Turner.
I mean, how do you follow that? Nobody wants a dirty glass. The five nominees for Talk Show Informative cover news, cooking, medical issues, and just about any interesting topics that come to mind.
They keep us thinking and sure enough keep us informed.
Here are the nominees.
The Chew, ABC. The Dr. Oz Show, syndicated. The Doctors, syndicated. The Kitchen, Food Network. Larry King Now, Aura TV.
And the outstanding Emmy goes to...
The Chew!
The Chew.
Accepting the Emmy, Gordon Elliott and Mark Schneider, executive producers.
Thank you. 6 years ago, a very courageous Brian Franz, president of ABC Daytime, and a very courageous Ann Sweeney decided they wanted to blend talk with food. It was a rather strange recipe. Came to an odd little cable company. Some people have been working with that odd cable company for over a decade behind me. And then we put together a show that was based on truth, friendship, utility, and authenticity. That comes from the production team behind it every day, comes from everyone in New York. And it comes from my great friends and work colleagues, Mark Schneider, Amy Householder. We've got Javon. My boys are here just for posterity. Carla Hall, my goodness, we'll come to the hosts in a moment, Ashley, Anthony, Maggie, but you can't do it without five great hosts who know what they are, who they are, and what they represent, and they do it, again, with great friendship and love, and all of them deserve a piece of this. Thank you very much for recognizing.
From Entertainment Tonight, please welcome Emmy winners Nancy O'Dell and Kevin Frazier.
Well, hello there, Daytime Emmys. Kevin and I are so thrilled to be with you tonight. And I think we also need to, Kevin, thank the Academy, because I do believe they gave us our lead story for Entertainment Tonight on Monday, right?
How will Kelly and Michael divide that Emmy?
They're going to share it. They are.
With a chainsaw. Anyway. We've been asked to present an award and guide you through the next few segments.
But first, we would like to share with you something that happened Friday night.
Yeah. We added a new award for Outstanding Musical Performance in a Daytime Program. Our winner was Rachel Platten.
And this award was presented Friday night at our Creative Arts Ceremony. And Rachel was working, so she sent us this message.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves and emotion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain, I will scream all my life tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight.
I want to thank the Emmys for this absolutely incredible honor. Getting to shut down Times Square and plaster my fight song GMA all over the billboards was so surreal. Thank you, Monica Escobedo and the Good Morning America team, for your drive and talent and vision in helping make this segment come to life. I love you guys so, so much, and I'm so honored.
'Cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me.
All right, well, our next order of business is to give an Emmy Award to the Outstanding Informative Talk Show Host.
Now, all five nominees host shows that are indeed informative and each uniquely different from the other. And yes, we are pitting a father against a daughter.
Which is not very nice, Kevin.
Kelly and Michael figured out they can.
Well, here are the nominees for Informative Talk Show Host.
Mario Batali, Carla Hall, Clinton Kelly, Daphne Oz, Michael Simon, The Chew, ABC. Steve Harvey, Steve Harvey, syndicated. Larry King, Larry King Now, Aura TV. Dr. Mehmet Oz, The Dr. Oz Show, syndicated. Peter Salgo, Second Opinion, PBS.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
And the Emmy goes to...
Wow.
Dr. Oz. The Dr. Oz Show.
I want you guys coming up here, seriously. I'm honored for this award. It's very emotional for me because we have done so much. So Justin, please come up here. Do not embarrass me. I'm asking you one time. The awkwardness about being a host is that you're actually a guest in people's homes. And you go in their homes every single day and you bring people with you who you love dearly. And in a medical talk show in particular, and I see my colleagues out there from the doctors as well, you know it, you can't do the show without some very bright people. Brighter than me, frankly. Each of these folks could have been physicians, and they came up. And what they tell me, it's actually a tip I got from Candy Carter years ago when I was still doing the Oprah show. And I'll give it to all of you. It's my one assignment maybe you can do tonight. Ask three people that you like and who like you. That's important. They have to like you. Ask three people who like you why they like you. And they're going to probably give you the same answer. You'll be surprised. Whoever that person is, you bring that person onto the stage with you, because that's the authenticity the audience at home wants. I love all the folks behind me dearly. They direct the show, they produce the show, they edit the show, they can make anything look good, and Amy Carroll's my EP. Get over here, and Stacey Rader. I bless them all. Thank you very much.
Dr. Oz's wife.
I dropped my paper. She's over there. I love, without Lisa, there is no Mehmet Oz. Trust me, Dr. Oz was her creation. It's her vision board. I'm really sorry, guys.
I'm glad you remember that.
Yeah. He has to go home tonight. We have now reached a point in the evening where we're just going to pause for a second to remember those people in the daytime industry. We'll ask for everybody to pipe down a little bit. You guys in the back, I know there's lots of conversations, but we want to pay tribute to the people that we have lost since the last time we were all together. So let's quiet down so we can give a tribute to our colleagues.
And you know, as they worked in television, their legacies are preserved forever, so we're very lucky for that.
To assist us, please welcome Miss Julie Garnier.
Changed for this, I just can't.
So many great performers and people who contributed to daytime television. Thank you so much for that beautiful song, too. All right, Julie Garnier.
And we, of course, also want to acknowledge our band, Caleb Nelson and the Remotes.
Now, please welcome the chairman of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, Chuck Dagas.
Good evening. As the chairman of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, it is with great pleasure that we gather tonight, this evening, to honor the many nominees and industry professionals that make up our daytime television community. As our industry continues to change at an ever-increasing rate, it's exciting to see that daytime television continues to meet the challenges of today's audience with programming that is decisive, inclusive, innovative, and inspiring. Throughout daytime television's many genres, the problems and topics that occupy our national dialogue are talked about, dramatized, analyzed, in ways that provide viewers with insight and clarity into the unique and thought-provoking. Whether it's informational entertainment or just plain daytime television, it's part of the fabric of our country and our audiences, inspiring new ideas, understanding, and giving perspective on life's issues. It is with great pleasure that we celebrate tonight's nominees and the individuals behind, both in behind and in front of the camera, that permit daytime television to continue to innovate, touch our imaginations of so many of us each day. Thank you so much.
From the young and the restless, please welcome Jason Thompson and Gina Tognetti.
Entertainment news programs with their five distinctive styles have become an essential tool for our keeping up with the goings-on in our industry.
So if you want to be part of the conversation at work the next day, well, you've got to watch. You got to be there, be square kind of thing, right?
Here are the nominees.
That is the Justin Access Hollywood, NBC, Entertainment Tonight, CBS, I can't. Extra, syndicated. The Insider, CBS, TMZ, syndicated.
And the Emmy for Entertainment News Program goes to...
Extra Syndicated.
Gregoris Dempsey, executive producer.
Carmella. Thank you to the Daytime Emmys. Thank you to, where's DRO? Where's Donna? Donna, Mike Darnell, Val Staub, Ted Harper, everybody at NBC, Carmella. And team right here, you know, it really is a team effort. We have a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun, but to be able to deliver the news, the entertainment news every day with such a fun group makes it all the worthwhile. So to be recognized, thank you very much. Muchas gracias.
From General Hospital, please welcome Emmy Award winner, Laura Wright.
Hi.
here tonight to present an Emmy Award to one of five superb actors with five incredible storylines. A man who has hidden his identity from his wife after major plastic surgery deals with the revelation of the truth. A man confronting the secrets of his past, portraying himself and his own father. A man confronting cancer and its physical and psychological challenges. A father consumed by guilt and grief as his son is lying in a hospital. A man confronting guilt and emotion after a triangular and very complicated family relationship. Here are the nominees for Outstanding Lead Actor in a Drama Series.
Tyler Christopher as Nicholas Cassadine, General Hospital, ABC. Anthony Geary as Luke Spencer and Tim Spencer, General Hospital, ABC. Justin Hartley as Adam Newman, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Christian LeBlanc as Michael Baldwin, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Christoph St. John as Neil Winters, The Young and the Restless, CBS.
And the Emmy goes to...
What an honor. And they say, I guess those who say things, that it's about the journey and not the end result. And that couldn't be truer for me tonight after 20 years of being on the best show in daytime television. And so I want to make it about the people who got me here in the beginning, rather than make it about how I feel I got myself here. So I'm gonna start with my wife, Brienne. I love you. And then I'm gonna go to Stephen Nichols. Where are you, brother? I told you I'd do it, man. You were my first mentor, my first teacher. You gave me this book, To the Actor, by Chekhov. And I appreciate it, and I'm not here without you. And I share this with you. Jonathan Jackson, Jeannie Francis, and Tony Geary. As a young green actor, I had not done anything before, and I come on and I'm thrust upon you, and you could have just shunned me off as any other green actor that hadn't, and just a passerby, and you embraced me. And for that, I share that with you. Mark Teschner, I have to do this because in 1996, I forgot to thank you at the Soap Digest Award. I've been kicking myself in the ass ever since. And I'm so thankful that I've got an opportunity to redeem myself. Ron Gallivardi and Frank, thank you for entrusting me with this story. And look, you're only as good as your other half. So Becky Herbst, Little Nick. All right, I got you, bro. I got you. You make it real easy. Nancy Grahn, you were part of this, and a bunch of other people. And lastly, I want to thank not just my family at General Hospital, but anyone who has ever worked in daytime television for the last 50 plus years. Congratulations, you killed it, and I share this with you.
From Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, The Bachelor, and The Bachelorette, please welcome Chris Harrison.
Good evening. It's
good to be here in my daytime capacity, representing my Who Wants to Be a Millionaire family. But let's talk drama. The five nominees for lead actress in a drama series rose to the challenge of five dramatic stories. A woman having to tell her brother he is dying and then process that information herself. A mother trying to cope with the unspeakable reality of her daughter being murdered. A woman trying to save her marriage while her husband struggles with his cancer diagnosis. A woman who thinks her life is over, not knowing that she has been saved. And a woman avenging the death of the love of her life. Now, on The Bachelor, we would call all of this drama a typical Sunday night. Here are the nominees.
Tracy E. Bregman as Lauren Fenimore Baldwin, The Young and the Restless, CBS. Cassie DePiva as Eve Larson, Days of Our Lives, NBC. Mary Beth Evans as Kayla Brady, Days of Our Lives, NBC. Finola Hughes as Anna DeVere, General Hospital, ABC. Maura West as Ava Jerome and Denise DiMuccio, General Hospital, ABC.
Good luck. And the Emmy goes to... Mary Beth Evans as Kayla Brady, Days of Our Lives.
This is Mary Beth's second Emmy win this year. She won Friday night for Outstanding Actress in a Digital Daytime Drama.
I totally watched The Bachelorette, so I loved it. Oh my gosh. Wow. Well, first off, the nominees in this category are all my friends. And you guys are amazing and fierce women, and I'm in awe to even be in your category. So thank you. And I look around this room and I just see so many faces I know, and I just think it's like a family reunion. And daytime was an incredible gift in my life. Thank you, Ken Corday, for letting me be a part of this incredible family and the incredible cast and crew of Days of Our Lives. They're amazing. To Bruce Evans, my absolute champion, and his mom, who I love. Michael Bruno, who's always my cheerleader. Dina Higley and Josh Griffin, who wrote the greatest stories for us this year and brought Stephen Nichols, my love, my partner, back into my life. Patch and Kayla. Albert Alar, I don't know where you are. There you are. Janet Ryder, you guys. I know there's more to your name, but you guys tweak every single scene I did this year, and I just love you from the bottom of my heart. Greg Ming, and I just have to say, the love of my life. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Shimar Moore.
All right, all right, all right. I always wanted to say that. Y'all having a good time? Let me hear the drunk people. Y'all having a good time? What I got right here is the last award of the night. So chug them back, and I'll see you at the after party. My Young and Restless family. My Young and Restless family. It's so good to come home. Malcolm Winters back in the building, baby. Neil Winters, I love you. Now, enough about Young and Restless. One of the four shows is going to win this thing tonight, so let's find out. Let's keep the party cracking. One of four daytime dramas. All of them are fierce. They have longevity. They have killer production values. They have casts and crews that are unparalleled in their skill, their talent, and their stamina. Now, each one of them deserves the Emmy we're about to give away tonight, but the job of the voters is to pick one show. So good luck. Your nominees, I almost opened the envelope. Here are your nominees for Outstanding Daytime Drama.
The Bold and the Beautiful, CBS. Days of Our Lives, NBC. General Hospital, ABC. The Young and the Restless, CBS.
And the Emmy goes to General Hospital.
Accepting the Emmy, Frank Valentini, executive producer.
This is going to be a little hard to do with this little guy next to me. He's quite a handful. First of all, we'd like to thank everyone at ABC, Ben Sherwood, Vicki Dummer, Nathan Varney, Val McMichael, Marla Provencia, Heidi Title, Heidi LaBelle, everyone in sales, this incredible crew. On behalf of the amazing cast led by Laura Wright and Maurice Bernard, we'd like to just thank everyone in the Academy for this. I'm sorry, I'm really nervous. This is my first time, so I'm really excited. Thank you, everyone. We love you. And the writers, I'm so sorry. I forgot to thank the writers, Ron Carlovati, for his unparalleled passion, and my amazing producing team, and the producers. And Gene Passanante and Shelley Altman, and I promise next time I'll be so much better.
These guys, and listen, everyone had such a great time, kept the show moving. Now it's time to party, right, Kevin?
There's going
to
be a heck of a party. We will see everybody right back here next year for the 44th Annual Daytime Emmy Awards. Take care, everybody.
That's right.
We'll see you soon.
Bye.
Congratulations. Bye. Congratulate tonight's nominees and winners. Until next time, for the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, this is Randy West.